Hey, what's up, guys? It's Jessica, and welcome to CritIC, the Pharmacokinetics series. In these series, I'll take you through the pharmacokinetic steps of absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion with a separate video on clearance and half-life. I'm making these videos with young physicians in mind, focusing on why these steps are important and how you can apply them in daily clinic life, and also as a step up for future videos. Now, let us commence. When you prescribe a drug to your patient, you'd want that drug to have a certain clinical effect. Let's take a look at metoprolol, a selective beta-1 receptor blocker. Beta-1 receptors increase heart rate and heart contractility and promote renin release, which leads to an increase in blood pressure. So blocking these would cause a decrease in heart rate, a decrease in contractility, and a decrease in blood pressure, making the heart a bit more energy efficient. Unfortunately for us, the patient isn't taking this drug directly on their beta-1 receptor, but usually through the mouth. You can imagine that the dose that patient takes isn't directly corresponding with the dose on the receptors. The drug undergoes some changes. This is pharmacokinetics. Not what the drug will do to the body, but what the body does to the drug. And we'll talk about this step by step, starting with how the drug gets into the bloodstream in absorption, how it is distributed throughout the body in distribution, and how it is cleared by the body either through metabolism, through excretion, or by a combination of both. I've broken these down into separate videos, so be sure to check these out. My goal is that after these series, you'll be able to look at your patient's medication, and for each drug, you'll be able to do the following if needed. Let's look at metoprolol, and let's say our patient uses 50 milligrams 2 times a day, meaning not slow release. The bioavailability is 50 to 70% by great first pass effect. The volume of distribution is 5.5 liters per kilogram. That's quite large. So it must be low in protein binding, it's only 12%, and it's probably lipid soluble. If it is, it will probably be metabolized by the liver greatly because it cannot be excreted by the kidney directly. For metabolism, metoprolol is primarily a substrate of CYP2D6, so I should pay attention to 2D6 inhibitors like Prozac and inducers. Also, 2D6 has high genetic variability. However, my patient uses 100 milligrams a day with good clinical effect, so that most likely isn't an issue. Excretion is performed by the kidney. About 5% is unchanged. The rest are metabolites, so renal injury isn't a problem with metoprolol. Concluding, possible problem with metoprolol, co-medication that influences CYP2D6, and liver failure. At first, it will take quite some time to do this for your patient's list of medication, but after a while, you'll be able to do a lot of this by heart. So please go through the next couple of videos on absorption, distribution, clearance and half-life, metabolism, and excretion. If you like these series, please share them and give them a thumbs up. Also, let me know in the comments what you would like to see more of. Thanks so much.